Hey, what is up, everybody? It's your boy back with y'all with a real quick short video for y'all today, and let's talk about next gen prices of video games. Alrighty, people, so y'all know that NBA 2K21 was the first one to come out with a price hike for next gen as a Xbox Series X and PlayStation 5 at $69. And I think there was even a $79 version, even a $99 version. Are y'all ready for this? Do y'all want to pay more for these next gen games? Even though right now on Steam, you can get them really cheap via PC. But that's where it changes. Next one that followed suit was Call of Duty. The cross-gen version is $69. The special edition, I think, is $79 or even $99. I may be wrong. I'm trying to have pictures showing up for you right here. Are y'all happy about this? Are y'all ready to have to pay more for your games for the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X and S? Honestly, $10, it's all matter of opinion. Yes, I'm willing to pay 10 more bucks for what they're going to be offering. Next-gen graphics, which I don't know if the graphics are truly going to be next-gen, because last gen was next-gen. I think even the gen before was considered next-gen. So we're the next-gen of the next-gen of the next-gen. It is what it is. This one just announced Godfall. Hopefully I got that right. Trying to remember everything that I looked at and read up on. Just announced that they were going to be doing a price hike on their game. For being a new IP, it's okay. I'm going to get a new experience, something that we haven't played. This isn't God of War, another Call of Duty, or another Halo, another Forza, another Need for Speed. This isn't those games that we've been playing for the past two generations. This is something that's new, as far as I know, because I've never heard of any other game called this. Now, it all depends, like I said, on where you stand by paying this extra money for video games. Now, back in the day, when Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, I even think the Sega Saturn, maybe even Dreamcast, video games back in the day costed different prices all over, from as low as $29.99 all the way up to $79.99. And some of these were Super Nintendo games, even Sega Genesis games. So I think just due to the fact that if you take into consideration that what we're getting now these days, and people want to complain about video games and their prices, man, I had to pay those prices back in the day. Yeah, I am an older cat, but I still love video games. It still takes me out of reality when it comes down to it. So I'm willing to pay that extra cash to get what I want. Great content, great games. I won't pay $79 for a sports title. Sports titles themselves, different genres of games like sports titles, the whole sports category. From FIFA to basketball, football, to even the track and field games that come out with Nintendo. All those should be cheap. I understand that you gotta have that price to make your money back. And, you know, studios are not doing this for free. But sports titles should be at the low end of the prices. racing title should be a little bit more, fighting title should be more, and then you get into your hardcore adventure, action shooters, those are all going to be what they are. Like I said, are you ready for these price hikes? Because 2K, Call of Duty, and now this Godfall, and there's no telling what other titles are going to be coming out in the future with this price. These new prices are $10 more. I don't know. But let me know what you think down below in the comment section. This is a real quick short video for y'all today. I know it's all over the place. Try to remember everything that I was looking at and read up on. But I'm trying. This new kind of content, it is what it is. Can't complain at the end of the day. I thought I would do this for y'all. Let me know, like I said, down below in the comments, are you willing to pay a little bit more for these next gen titles? Anyways, till the next one. Peace, y'all.